Welcome to the Adobe Admin Console video on Enterprise Storage Management. In this video, we will discuss the Enterprise Storage Model, Business IDs and Adobe Profiles, along with how to reclaim and manage transferred assets. For an organization, one of the biggest drawbacks of the Adobe ID Type 1 identity is that the end user holds control of all the assets and storage pertaining to the account which was paid for and provided by their organization. Companies expect control over cloud data to mitigate IP risks and to transfer assets when an employee leaves the organization. Therefore, to meet these expectations, Enterprise Storage Model ESM was introduced. Some of the key highlights of ESM are as follows. ESM is a Creative Cloud storage solution provided to the Creative Cloud for Teams and Creative Cloud for Enterprise customers. This model allows the organizations to manage the cloud storage in the Adobe Admin Console, which is not available with Adobe ID Type 1. With the introduction of ESM, each team user gets 1 terabyte of cloud storage. All the cloud storage of a team/enterprise account is pooled, which allows the admins to access all the user's data in one place. Admins can view the cloud storage used by each user in the Adobe Admin Console. Now let's understand Adobe Storage for Business. Adobe Creative Cloud accounts come with cloud storage, meaning your user's assets are available anywhere, from any connected device or computer. Users can access creative assets directly from Creative Cloud Desktop, as well as within any of your Creative Cloud apps, mobile, and web apps. Examples of assets that sync to storage are cloud documents, libraries, mobile creations, Lightroom images, and PDFs. Now, all user storage quotas are combined and shared across your whole team, so those who need more storage can access the remaining storage space. With this update, allocation is based on the total storage amount purchased instead of per license. For example, if an organization purchases 50 Creative Cloud licenses, each user still gets the entitled amount of storage, but now any user can exceed their entitled allocation if the organization hasn't exceeded its total amount of allocated storage. This cloud storage upgrade applies to Creative Cloud for Teams and enterprise plans with commercial and government customers. Increased cloud storage enables members of your team to create cloud documents in Creative Cloud libraries easily and share them in creative workflows. With these updates, admins have full control and visibility of storage across Creative Cloud applications. After Adobe Storage for Business is provisioned for your organization, a storage tab is displayed in the admin console. Admins can view the quota used by individual users and the overall quota consumed by all the users. You can also manage folders with shared ownership for collaboration and private folders of individual users. We've made it easier for admins to transfer users' content when they leave the company, since your organization owns the user accounts and their associated content. When a user leaves the organization or you delete a user's account, you can retrieve the assets from user folders and transfer them to another user through the Adobe Admin Console. The user's folder is moved under the Inactive Users page in the Storage tab, and you have an option to transfer the user's assets to a delegated user. All assets are added to a compressed file archive, and the link to download the file is sent to the designated user through email. Let's see a step-by-step process of how to reclaim the asset. Whenever you remove a user, if the affected user has assets stored in their Adobe Storage for Business folders, you're prompted to reclaim the assets. In the Admin Console, select a user to remove. From the list of options, choose one of the following, and then click Next. Transfer content now. Folder content is sent through email to a designated user. If you choose this option, specify the email address of the designated user that receives the content. You can specify the email address of any supported identity type of a user in your organization. Transfer content later. The folder content remains in the Inactive User tab until it is permanently deleted. Permanently delete content. The folder is permanently deleted with no option to retrieve the content. If you select Transfer Content Now, the users receive an email with a link to download the compressed archives. Each compressed archive can be up to 5 gigabytes based on the total size of assets stored in the user's folder. Depending on the size of the assets, it can take a while for you to receive the email. If you select Transfer Content Later, you can navigate to the Inactive Users tab and the Folder Details pane will open. Click on 3 dots, and then choose Edit Folder Access. Specify the email address of the designated user and click Add. You can specify the email address of any supported identity type of a user in your organization. You can also define the access level, edit, or view, and save. The delegated users receive an email with a link to download the compressed archives. Each compressed archive can be up to 5 gigabytes depending on the total size of assets stored in the user's folder. Depending on the size of the assets, it can take a while for you to receive the email. Once the designated users receive an email with a link to download the compressed archives, there are limitations to the type of assets that can be reclaimed. See Assets that can be reclaimed to know which assets can be part of the archive. Depending on the size of the original assets, multiple archives may be created. Each compressed archive can be up to 5 gigabytes. The email is sent when all the archives are created. Therefore, there can be a delay in the designated user receiving the email. In the Storage Reports section, you can create and download storage reports for further analysis. Adobe is also introducing Business IDs to give organizations better control over their assets. Business IDs do not require a complicated setup, such as claiming a domain or configuring SSO. You can add users with any email address, including public email domains such as Gmail or Outlook. If your users have multiple Adobe plans associated with the same email address, Adobe will create separate profiles with dedicated storage for each of their plans. To easily work and organize content across your business and individual plans, your users will be able to select a profile, business or personal, at sign-in, and then proceed to create and store content. This improves the way your users and your business store, manage, and securely collaborate on creative projects. If your users receive an Adobe plan from an organization such as a business, government entity, or educational institution, then the Adobe profile associated with that plan is a business profile. Content stored in business profiles may be accessed or controlled by the organization providing the business plan. The content is only accessible to the user and the plan administrator. It is not accessible to others on the team unless it is shared with them. If you or your users want to switch profiles, simply sign out and sign back in. After entering your credentials, the profile chooser is displayed and you can select the profile of your choice. Link to this video are guides describing how to administer Adobe Enterprise Storage, reclaim and manage transferred assets, business IDs, and Adobe profiles.